following program is from NET, the Public Television Network.
You got here too, because I want you to spread the word. Today is the day that Michael Cooney comes to Sesame Street. Michael Cooney, don't forget. I want you to stick around for this. Everybody, hey Bob.
Hi, Gordon, how you doing?
Good to see you. Listen, Michael Cooney's coming today.
Oh, great! Yeah. He got his banjo.
Got his banjo.
Terrific.
Got the whole
work. I'll go tell him.
Okay, don't you forget.
No.
Come here because Sesame Street's gonna really swing today. Michael Cooney. Hey, Tracy and Leslie, listen. Michael Cooney's coming today. Okay, go spread the word. Okay, they know. Bob knows. I'll go tell Susan in a minute. Hey, I wonder if Ernie and Bert know.
I love my rubber ducky. I love my rubber ducky.
Ernie.
I love my
Ernie.
What, Bert?
Ernie.
Yeah?
You promised me you'd have this place cleaned up before lunchtime. Now, you promised me that.
Oh, well, don't worry, Bert. I will. I will.
Boy.
You know, spick and span by lunchtime. Sure.
Oh, yeah? Now stop that with a ducky.
Okay.
Look,
sorry.
For your information, Ernie, we're going to have lunch in just a minute or two.
Mm-hmm.
And you got a couple of hours' work here to get this whole mess cleaned up.
Oh, no, Bert. No. Not the way I work. Because I am the fastest cleaner-upper you ever saw.
Oh, yeah?
Why, once I get going, I am a regular white tornado.
Yeah, well, listen, if you can clean this mess up before lunchtime, you're Superman.
I bet I can do it.
Now, cut that out with a ducky.
Hmm.
I bet you can't. You've only got a minute left before lunch.
Okay, what do you want to bet, Bert?
I bet you my dessert.
Dessert?
Yeah, if you do it, I'll give you my dessert.
Ha. Oh, well, what's for dessert today? Because I don't do my super-fast cleanup job just for any old dessert, you know.
Cookies and ice cream.
Cookies? Cookies and ice cream?
Yep.
Cookies and ice cream? That's my favorite dessert of
I
all
know.
Times. Okay, you're on. How much time have I got?
You have 15 seconds.
15 seconds.
Yeah.
Stand back.
Okay.
Here goes old Ernie, faster than a speeding bullet. On your mark, get set, go. For cookies and ice cream, I can do anything. Come on, Bert, lunchtime.
It's not fair. It's just not fair.
Hey, I promised you, right? And here he is. This is Michael Cooney. Say hello.
Say hello.
Hi.
That's Michael Cooney.
I have a song that I've been singing around, and I'd like you to learn it. And it's a...
Every time I sing it someplace, I sing it a little different. And the reason is, a long time ago, this song is so old, a long time ago, everybody who sang it with the name of his own town. And then when it came time to write it down, or they wrote down, they just picked one name because they couldn't write all the towns in the world, so they wrote Buffalo. And they call it Buffalo Gals. Well, I'd like to sing it Sesame Street Gals, because that's where we are on Sesame Street. And I want you to sing this with me. Sesame Street Gals, won't you come out tonight? Come out tonight, come out tonight. Sesame Street Gals, won't you come out tonight and dance by the light of the moon? You sing that? Sesame Street Gals, won't you come out tonight? Come out tonight. Walking down the street, a pretty little girl I chanced to meet, and she was fair to see. Sesame Street gals, won't you come out tonight? Come out tonight, come out tonight. Sesame Street gals, won't you come out tonight and dance by the light of the moon? I stopped her and we had some talk, had some talk, had some talk. Her feet covered up the whole sidewalk and left no room for me. Oh, Sesame Street gals, won't you come out tonight? Come out tonight, come out tonight. Sesame Street gals, won't you come out tonight and dance by the light of the moon? I danced with a dolly with a hole in her stocking, and her knees kept knocking, and her toes kept rocking. I danced with a dolly with a hole in her stocking, and we danced by the light of the moon. Oh, Sesame Street gals, won't you come out tonight?
Got another instrument. He's got a guitar.
Oh, right?
Mike, can we clap our hands on this one?
Oh, if you like. This is another song I'd like you to sing the chorus with me. A friend of mine made this up, and I really like songs that people can make up.
Wait,
your time, Tracy. Go ahead, Mike. Those are picks.
What's this one all about?
See, he's putting on his finger. Those are picks.
This is a song a friend of mine in California made up, and I really like to see people make up songs, and some of them are really easy to make up. And especially songs about whatever you feel like making, whatever you're thinking about. And this fellow had a job one summer picking apples, and I think that sounds like a lot of fun. And he did too, and he taught it to a bunch of his friends, and I learned it pretty soon, and it's getting around, and I'd like you to learn it too. And the chorus goes, it's a little hard to sing the chorus, but you listen very closely to the words, and we'll sing it a couple of times. It goes like this. Hey-ho makes you feel so fine, looking out across the orchard in the bright sunshine. Hey-ho makes you feel so free, standing in the top of an apple tree. Hey-ho makes you feel so fine, looking out across the orchard in the bright sunshine. Hey-ho makes you feel so free, standing in the top of an apple tree. Oh, I know it's hard to say, but by the time of the end of the song, you'll have it learned. Up in the morning before the sun, I don't get home until the day is done. My pick-sack's heavy and my shoulder's sore, gotta be back tomorrow to pick some more. Hey-ho makes you feel so fine, looking out across the orchard in the bright sunshine. Hey-ho makes you feel so free, standing at the top of an apple tree. Start at the bottom and you pick them from the ground, and you pick that tree clean all the way around. Then you set up your ladder and you climb up high, and you're looking through the leaves at the clear blue sky. Hey-ho makes you feel so fine, looking out across the orchard in the bright sunshine. Hey-ho makes you feel so free, and you stop up an apple tree. Ladder, wobbly as heck, reaching for an apple, whoops, almost fell. 20-pound sack hanging around my neck, and there's two more apples that I can't quite get. Hey-ho makes you feel so fine, looking out across the orchard in the bright sunshine. Hey-ho makes you feel so free, standing on top of an apple of an apple tree.
Now back to, what's that called, the instrument? What's he got?
A guitar.
No, no, this one. What?
Banjo.
Banjo, you sure?
Yep.
You're right.
That's
okay.
A B word.
And
right.
That one has five strings. Michael said some of them only have four, but his has five strings.
And some of them have six.
Some of them have six.
Most of them have four or five, though. Well, here's a song that's a lot easier to sing. And this is another song I really like. This is a song that was made up by a grown-up, but it was made up for fellow's own little kids. And it seems to me there are a lot of things that are no fun to do in this world sometimes, and it's really nice when parents make up songs that make things easier to do. There are things like getting up in the morning and going to bed at night and cleaning up your room and helping somebody else clean up his room. And one of my favorite songs is a song to make taking a bath easier, if you don't like to take a bath. And sometimes I don't, sometimes I do. So here's one. And once you learn this, you realize you can make up your own verses as long as you want. It goes like this. Oh, mama, come wash my face. Come wash my face. Come wash my face. Mama, oh, mama, come wash my face. And make it nice and clean, oh. You see, with a song like that, all you have to do is name places to wash, as long as you feel like it. Oh, daddy, come scrub my back. Come scrub my back. Come scrub my back. Daddy, oh, daddy, come scrub my back. And make it nice and clean, oh. You can sing that just as long as you feel like. Maybe if you run out of places to wash, you can always make up verses about anything. In fact, it's really fun to make up nonsense word verses. Here's a good one, of course. Oh, clean, oh, clean. Oh, clean, oh, clean. Oh, clean, oh, clean. Oh, clean, oh, clean. Rub-dub-dubbity. Scrub, scrub, scrubbity. Making me nice and clean, oh. If you can't think of a nonsense verse, you still gotta sing. Well, you don't have to sing about washing. Maybe you can sing about something like, brother, oh brother, come shine my shoes. Come shine my shoes. Come shine my shoes. Brother, oh brother, come shine my shoes. And polish them nice and clean, oh. I think at the end it's really fun to sing something like, oh sweetie, come smell me now. Come smell me now. Come smell me now. Oh sweetie, come smell me now. Don't I smell nice and clean, oh.
Hey, very good. You know what, Michael, that reminds me of a song we sing here on Sesame Street. It's called Everybody Wash, and it goes like this.
Hey, you out there in TV land, everybody wash! Everybody wash your ears! Everybody wash your hands! Everybody wash your chest. Everybody wash your everything. That's right. Keep washing. Keep washing, everybody.
Hey, that looks nice, Gordon.
Yeah, I like that. Like
hey, what happened to Mike, by the way?
Mike, oh, the kids took him down to meet Oscar.
That should be a barrel of laughs.
Yeah, Willie meets Oscar.
Oh, hi, Gordon.
Hello,
Big Bird. Hi, Big Bird.
How are
you? Hey, what's that you're working on there?
Oh, this is a letter I, Big Bird.
Oh, letter I?
Sure.
Where'd you get the letter I?
Oh, the boys in my shop class made it for the first grade teacher. And I brought it home. Gordon said you'd give me a hand painting it, and we're just finishing up here. Hey, I'm out of paint, Gordon. Have you got any others?
No, I'm fresh out too, Bob. I don't have a thing left.
Where can we get some? I think Mr. Hooper's got some in his back room over in his store. I'll go check over there, all right?
Yeah, you know, I think there's some down in the basement over here. Let me check.
Oh, by the way, Big Bird, would you do me a favor?
Surely. What is it?
Would you keep your eye on this letter I for me? And don't let anybody touch it, because it's still wet, and I don't want to get it all messed up, all right?
Aye, aye, sir.
Okay. Thanks, Bruce.
I will watch that eye like a real bird dog. Boy, I sure wouldn't want anything to happen while I was watching that, because usually I do everything wrong. But I don't see what could go wrong. But, aye, 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 it fell off. Hey, little eye dot, you're supposed to be up on top. Let me just pick it up. Yep, yipes. This is funny. Come back here, little eye. Yeah. This seems weird. Come back. Here. Oops. How do you like that? I don't like it one bit. It's going to be dirty bouncing around. Now, stop that. Now, just come here. It's gone. It's gone. I couldn't do one little thing right, like take care of a dot on an eye. Oh, woe is me. Oh, I've done it again. Oh.
Hey, I got some more paint here.
Yeah, hey, I got some too.
Oh, you probably got too much now.
Oh, well.
Hey, thanks for taking care of the eye for us, Bert.
The eye? Aye, aye, aye. It's back.
What's back, Big Bird?
The dot. The dot on that eye there. It ran away. Bounced off, and I chased it, and it went right over the fence, and then... And I turned around, it's back.
That's pretty funny, Big Bird.
This dot, Big Bird?
That dot, yes, right there.
Oh, Big Bird, that's impossible. This dot is made out of plywood. We made it ourselves. Listen to that. That can't bounce.
Look, Big Bird, that dot is on solidly. It can't bounce all over the yard. It's on here.
Yeah, but...
Oh, look, Big Bird, dots can do a lot of things, right? They can show movies, but they just cannot bounce all over a yard.
Show movies?
Yeah, dots show movies. Watch.
Ice cream. Strawberry ice cream. My favorite kind.
Now, you see what I mean? That dot can show movies, but Big Bird, it can't bounce all over the yard. You've got a wild imagination.
But I did. I saw it. There! Oh. Look! There! What? There! It's bouncing again. There.
Where's it going?
Up.
Hey, you know, that dot hit me on the head 2 times.
Hey, is Oscar always that grouchy?
Yes.
Oh, I hope we get to go see him again. Thanks a lot. That was really nice. Listen, in exchange for you letting me visit with Oscar, can I teach you a game?
Yeah.
I think it's really neat. I really like games, and I want to learn to play more games, and I hope you can remember this, because I really like to do this. Oh, this is really easy. All you have to do is do whatever I do, and whenever I say something, you say it right back at me, all right?
Okay.
I say... Let's go on a bear hunt.
Let's go on a bear hunt.
Ooh, look.
Ooh, look.
There's a stream.
There's a stream.
Can't fly over.
Can't fly over.
Can't go around.
Can't go around.
Gotta swim across.
Gotta swim across.
Okay, here goes. That was fun.
That was fun.
Ooh, look.
Ooh, look.
There's a lake.
There's a lake.
Can't fly over.
Can't fly over.
Can't go under.
Can't go under.
Gotta row across.
Gotta row across.
Ooh, look.
Ooh, look.
Swans on the lake.
Swans on the lake.
Let's go on a bear hunt.
Let's go on a bear hunt.
Ooh, look.
Ooh, look.
There's some tall grass.
There's some tall grass.
Let's go through the tall grass.
Let's go through the tall grass.
Ooh, look.
Ooh, look.
There's some short grass.
There's some short grass.
Let's go through the short grass. Ooh, look.
Ooh, look.
There's a small tree.
There's a small tree.
Let's climb up and see what we can see.
Let's climb up and see what we can see.
Down the tree. Ooh, look.
Ooh, look.
There's a middle-sized tree.
There's a middle-sized tree.
Let's climb up and see what we can see.
Let's climb up and see what we can see. Oh, I see something.
Down the tree.
I see
something. Let's go on a bear hunt.
Let's go on a bear hunt.
Ooh, look.
Ooh, look.
There's a big tree.
There's a big tree.
Let's climb up and see what we can see.
Let's climb up and see what we can see.
Down the tree.
Ooh,
look.
Ooh, look.
There's a cave.
There's a cave.
Let's go in and see what we can see. Ooh. It's dark in here. Now, you feel the head of the person next to you. Ooh, I feel something. It's warm. It's furry. It's a bear. Run! Hurry! Up the big tree. Down the big tree.
I know all of that.
Hurry! Up the middle-sized tree. Down the middle-sized tree. Run! Up the little tree. Down the little tree. Do the short grass.
Big grass.
Hurry. Do the long grass. Over the lake. Run back home and close the door. I wasn't scared. Were you?
No.
That's really nice.
Hey, that was a pretty wild bear hunt you guys went on. Tired?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
You too?
Yeah.
Okay. Tell you what, gather around. I know you're not tired. Gather around here for what they will read a story, okay? Because you're probably worn out.
You tired?
Are you tired, Ronald?
Yeah.
You are? Okay, I just wanted to check with you. Huh? Oh, you got all your energy out. Okay. All right, look, this is a story called Where Are the Mothers? And it's all about what mothers do while you're doing something else. Like if you're in school, what your mother may be doing, or if you're out playing, what your mother may be doing at that time, okay? You do, huh? Okay, you want to tell me about it? She's working while you're at school. Okay, we'll probably find one like you. It's called Where Are the Mothers? And it begins like this. It's time for school. They're on the way. But where are their mothers during the day? Now, while Joseph paints a picture, his mother paints the kitchen. See, that's what Joseph's mother does. While Linda and Lyle learn numbers, their mother works in an office. Is anybody's mother work in an office?
No.
Yeah? Okay.
My mother works in school.
Oh, she works in school. Good. So. Now, while Susan strings beads, her mother makes Susan's new dress. Any of your, how about the little girls? Any of your mothers make dresses? Yours? Okay.
Not my mother.
Probably your mother doesn't make a dress for you.
She makes
For your sister,
she
maybe.
She makes
all
dresses
right.
for herself.
Okay, she makes dresses for herself. Now, while Michael learns to write, his mother writes to grandmother. While Tommy learns to read, his mother teaches in a nursery school. And while Jane plays house, her mother takes care of baby John. Any of you have baby brothers or sisters?
I have an older brother, but I know a boy that when he was a baby, he was
Oh, I'm glad to know that. You know a baby John. Okay, put your hands down now. We got to move on. While Bobby plays store, his mother works in a store. Any of your mothers work in stores? No? Okay. While Nina waters the plants at school, her mother plants roses at home. Now it's the weekend. And that's what everybody digs, a weekend, because, you know, you're away from school for a while and you get a couple of days to rest. Children and parents are together. Joseph and his family have a picnic. Ever been on a picnic? Mm-hmm. Yeah, you have? Good. Linda and Lyle and their mother bake a cake. Susan and her mother and brother go to the library. Ever been to the library? You have? Good, okay. Michael and his mother and Michael's friend George go to a movie. I know you've been to the movies, right? You like the movies? You've been there 1,000 times. Tommy and his family go swimming. You like swimming? You don't know how to swim?
I went to camp.
Good for you, Ronald. You went to camp. Okay, Sarah, good. Jane and her family go to visit grandmother and grandfather. And Bobby and his family go to the zoo. You like the zoo?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay. Lions and tigers and hippopotami, huh?
Elephants,
too, yeah. Nina's mother and father have a birthday party for her. Now it's Monday again. Back to school everywhere. Each child knows his place and is glad to be there. Now we know all about what your mothers do when you're doing something else, right?
Hiya. My name is Kermit, and today I'm here to talk to you about the letter F. Now, see this letter? This is the letter... No, it's not. Look at that. That's not an F. That's an E. I asked them for an F, and they sent me an E. Hey, you guys. Come here.
Yeah?
Look at this. Look at this.
What's the matter, Frog?
Look, I asked for an F, and you have delivered to me an E.
Yeah, so what's the difference?
What's the difference?
What's the difference?
Just look at it. Now, the E has three lines. You see, the E has got the top line, and it's got the middle line, and it's got the bottom line down here, you see? The F doesn't have those three. The F has got the top line, it's got the middle line, but see this part down here? The F doesn't have that part. That part there shouldn't belong. That doesn't belong there at all. Now, I can see if how you can send me an F.
There you go, Frog.
This is an F.
I wish I was. was in New Orleans sipping in his hand.
Song.
That's Candyman. Listen, I'd like to show you something. I don't know if you've ever seen one of these. This is called a jaw harp. And I really like this kind of instrument because there are a number of things like this that you can play without taking lessons, and that's what I like about it. Oh, we had a little chicken and it wouldn't lay an egg. We poured hot water up and down its leg. The little chicken cried and the little chicken begged. And the little chicken laid a hard-boiled egg. Have you ever been a-fishing on a bright and sunny day? Seen the little fishes swimming up and down the bay with their hands in their pockets and their pockets in their pants and all the little fishes doing a hoochie-coochie dance? Oh, I went to Cincinnati and I walked around the block. I walked right into a bakery shop. I picked 3 donuts out of the grease and I handed the lady a 5-cent piece. Well, she looked at the nickel and she looked at me. She said, "This nickel's no good to me. There's a hole in the middle and it's all the way through." Says I, "There's holes in the donuts too. Thanks for the donuts. Goodbye."
Hey, very good.
Okay.
There's an island way out in the seas where the babies, they all grow on trees. And it's jolly good fun to swing in the sun, but you gotta watch out if you sneeze, sneeze. You gotta watch out if you sneeze. You gotta watch out if you sneeze, for swinging up there in the breeze, you're liable to cough, you might very well fall off, and tumble down flop on your knees, knees, tumble down flop on your knees. And when the stormy winds wail, and the breezes blow high in a gale, there's a curious dropping and plopping and flopping, and fat little babies just hail, hail. Fat little babies just hail. And the babies lie there in a pile, and the grown-ups, they come after a while, and they always pass by all the babies who cry, and take only babies who smile, smile. Take only babies who smile, even triplets and twins if they'll smile.
Gotta keep smiling.
I'd like to finish up. I'd like to do you one more song.
And
this is a song about, you know, everybody has blood inside them. But some people's blood is different from other people's blood. But no matter where you live, there's always somebody someplace else, maybe far away, that has the same kind as you do. That's what this song is about. Close your eyes and point your finger on the map. Just let it linger any place you point your finger to. There's someone with the same type blood as you. England, China, or Alaska, Mexico, or Madagascar, makes no difference what they are or do. There's someone with the same type blood as you. No type of blood is better. No type of blood is best. Each type of blood is just as good, not better than the rest. In the mountains or in the valleys, rich hotels or slum-like alleys, any place you point your finger to, there's someone with the same type of blood as you. Plumbers, doctors, men of science, clerks or teachers, dwarfs or giants, makes no difference what they are or do. There's someone with the same type blood as you. It may be A or AB,
It may be B or O. No matter what the type is, sir, there's one thing you should know. Nature has no favorite nation, color, creed, or occupation. Any place you point your finger to, there's someone with the same type blood as you.
Thank you for coming by Sesame Street today. It's puzzling how you play so well and sing so well.
Do 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 do, sunny day, sweeping the clock. Hey, Ernie.
Hey, Bert.
Hey, Aaron, what do you got in the box there, huh?
This, Bert?
Yeah?
This is my ice cube collection.
Your what?
My ice cube collection. I bet you didn't even know I collected ice cubes, did you, Bert?
I didn't know anybody collected ice cubes.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I started yesterday. I gathered up all these really beautiful ice cubes, and I put them in this box. And then I put the box under the electric blanket.
The ice cubes? Mm-hmm. Underneath that electric blanket?
Oh, I had to, Bert. Those little fellows were freezing cold. But I kept them toasty warm all night. Hey, you want to see them?
Oh, Ernie, I'd love to.
Behold. Oh, no. Bert.
What?
Oh, no. My ice cubes.
Yeah?
They're gone. Oh, Bert.
Well, of
oh.
course they are, Ernie.
Oh, but why, Bert? Why? I was so kind to them. Why did my ice cubes run away from home, Bert?
Oh, Ernie, now that's silly. Ice cubes can't run away from home.
You're right.
Right.
They didn't even have suitcases or bus fares. Something must have happened to them.
True.
Bert.
Why?
I think I suddenly realized that I know what happened.
Well, about time, too.
Yes, somebody stole my ice cubes.
Oh, brother.
Somebody around here is a dirty ice cube thief. And when I find out who, he will pay for this.
Yeah.
I'll look for clues.
Yeah, you do that. Good idea. Why don't you look at the box real careful-like, you know?
Look at the box.
Maybe you'll figure out what really happened to the ice cubes.
Bert!
What?
Bert, look at this. I've found a clue. Take a look in the box here. Look in the box.
Yeah?
This box used to contain ice cubes.
Yeah?
But now it's full of water.
So it is.
Mm-hmm.
Now do you see what happened?
I certainly do.
Well, good.
Everything is perfectly clear.
At last.
A fish stole my ice cubes.
Why?
Some dirty fish sneaked under the electric blanket and stole my ice cubes.
I don't believe this.
That's what happened.
Ernie, don't you know what really happens when you take ice cubes out of the refrigerator? They melt.
The ice cubes melted?
That's right. They turned to water.
You mean the water in there used to be my ice cubes, and then they melted, and that is the water that my ice cubes used to be?
That's right. Now, do you still think that a fish stole your ice cubes?
Oh, no, of course not. That's a silly thought. No, I don't think that anymore.
Good boy. Now, tell me what really happened.
Some fish melted my ice cubes. Some dirty fish sneaked in here and melted my ice cubes. And when I catch that fish, I'm going to tear him fin from fin. Oh, wait till I get hold of him.
Go get him, Ernie.
Boy, that's what I call a lot of water. And this is what I call the lid of a trash can. You know that. And it's in pretty good shape now, but one day, it's going to get old and nobody's going to be able to use it anymore, so they'll take it down to a place called the scrapyard or junkyard. And there, they'll mash it all up with a lot of other metal pieces that aren't any good anymore. And they'll melt it down after a while and they'll make something new out of it. Hey, you know what was great about today on Sesame Street? Well, a lot of things. Michael Cooney, for one. He was a lot of fun. It's good of him to come by and join us. And how about Big Bird and that dot on the eye? He never did get over that. And Susan was here and Bob was here. We had a good time today and we're gonna have a good time the next time we come and join you. So you make sure you join us, okay? Take it easy.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters C, F, and I, and by the numbers 2 and 3. Where Are the Mothers? Was written and illustrated by Dorothy Marino, published by J.B. Lippincott Company, copyright 1959. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.